signs of the season are all around. You've seen it already. The holiday music in the stores and the walls, the various sidewalk Santas in the city, the lights, the untold numbers of commercials. Over the Thanksgiving weekend, I watched with my grandson the cartoon Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer 27 times. How could I count it? And it's just as bad as it sounds. For some of these, we cringe. For others, there's never too much glitz, never too much light, never too much noise. And people, I think, genuinely, at least, I think they do. They give voice to those familiar feelings of peace and goodwill, whatever goodwill actually means in the 21st century, joy and hope, cheer, light, love, all those things that are important to be associated with this time of year. But I'm going to hit you with some different words this morning. I want you to think about them really carefully. And they are the words of Scripture. The different words that starts the season of Advent are words of judgment, distress, and fear. Who'd like to get that on a Christmas card? And yet, they are part of the message. And I would be unfaithful to my role as a spiritual leader if I didn't bring that up and ask you to think about them really seriously. The readings we traditionally proclaim in Advent, we listen to a language which is called apocalyptic. And the imagery is intentionally disturbing. Signs in the heavens, distress among nations, the sun, the stars, and the moons behaving improperly. People fainting from fear. The Weather Channel will give you nothing but stories of Katrina. And if you don't make that up, the sermon ends right now. Here's the important when things begin to take place that upset you, then stand up, raise your heads, because your redemption is near at hand. When you most are sure that life is chaos, when you are least sure that faith has any meaning at all, when every instinct within you, when life is going nuts and your instinct says, duck, Jesus says, hold your head up high. Trust. It's not a matter of believing in God. Anyone can believe in God. What makes us believers is that we believe God. Forget the end. We believe God's word. We believe his promises are true. We believe that sickness and poverty and racism and pain and death and meaninglessness, those are not the purpose and end of human life. We put our trust in someone. Someone who does care. Someone who will judge. But more importantly, and most importantly, someone who has redeemed. So in a couple of weeks, either this church or in others, most of you will be singing words of a hymn, and you will sing, the hopes and fears of all the years are many me tonight. But another messenger also says this, don't be afraid, because those words are true. Keep your head up. And as dark as the darkness is in your life, your God will never abandon you.